My name is Yusupenko Katerina. I'm a second year medical student. I want to present you my report on the topic healthy habits, don't skip breakfast. Breakfast is often referred to as the most important meal of the day, and in recent years has been implicated in weight control, cardio metabolic risk factors, and cognitive performance also. There are extensive reports of breakfast contributions to daily food and nutrient intakes, as well as many studies that have compared daily food and nutrient intakes by breakfast consumers and skippers. It is frequently stated that breakfast is a very important meal and that it deserves special attention, especially among children, and this is borne out by published opinions of international agencies, national governments, and non-governmental organizations. One of the most wide-reaching reports is that of the European branch of the World Health Organization, who conducted a health behavior survey of over 200,000 male and female school children, 11 to 13 and 15 years of age in 39 European states in 2009-2010. Overall, 61% of 13-year-olds consumed breakfast on each school day, while the figure fell to 55% among 15-year-olds. In general, breakfast consumption was most common among boys and declined with lower socioeconomic status. This data shows that about half to one third of children don't have breakfast every day. Although the data doesn't reveal the actual frequency of breakfast intake. The report notes that regular breakfast consumption is associated with higher intakes of micronutrients, better diet that includes fruit and vegetables, and less frequent use of soft drinks. Also, the American Heart Association issued a scientific opinion in 2017 on meal timing and frequency, implications for cardiovascular disease prevention. As regards breakfast and nutrient balance, they cite a cross-sectional survey of the Bogalusa heart study, which demonstrated that 74% of breakfast skippers didn't meet two-thirds of the recommended dietary allowance for vitamins and minerals, compared with 41% of those who consumed breakfast. They also cite US data showing that young adults age from 20 to 39 years old who reported skipping breakfast had overall daily diets that were less than optimal in terms of nutrient intake. Taking into account the direct evidence linking breakfast intake both to overall dietary patterns and the presence of cardiometabolic risk factors, the statement concludes, on the basis of the combined epidemiological and clinical intervention data, daily breakfast consumption among US adults may decrease the risk of adverse effects related to glucose and insulin metabolism. In addition, comprehensive dietary counseling that supports daily breakfast consumption may be helpful in promoting healthy dietary habits throughout the day. Several large prospective studies support the association between breakfast consumption and lower risk of obesity and weight gain. Support for the association between skipping breakfast and impaired glucose metabolism comes from four prospective studies that link skipping breakfast with great risk of type 2 diabetes. The health professionals follow-up studies, nurses health study, a Japanese study, and the German EPIC cohort provide evidence that regular healthy breakfast consumption is associated with improved glycemic control. Several cross-sectional studies reported an inverse association between breakfast consumption and risk factors of cardiovascular disease. A prospective study of US health professionals documented an increase in incidence of CVD amongst those North American men who regularly failed to eat breakfast. Similarly, a study conducted in Japan showed that infrequent breakfast intake was associated with an increased risk for total CVD, total stroke, and for cerebral hemorrhage. However, it was not associated with greater risk of subarachnoid hemorrhage, cerebral infarction or coronary heart disease in this population. Data from a Spanish cohort PESA, progression of early subclinical atherosclerosis, further supports the suggestion that skipping breakfast is associated with increased odds of prevalent non-coronary and generalized atherosclerosis independently of the presence of conventional cardiovascular risk factors. Taken together, data from prospective studies support consistent and strong cross-sectional evidence suggesting that breakfast consumption is associated with a reduction of cardiometabolic risk factors. Breakfast intake also is frequently related to mental alertness. Much of the research in breakfast and its potential effects on improving cognitive performance has been conducted in children and adolescents. A recent meta-analysis examined the literature on breakfast consumption versus breakfast skipping and also the nutritional composition of consumed breakfasts. There was evidence to support improved cognitive function, particularly short-term benefits on attention, executive function, and memory. The authors concluded that there were insufficient studies to draw any firm conclusions. Similarly, a review in adults that included 38 studies reported small effects on memory. but emphasized that strong conclusions are hampered by methodological disparity. So I think that eating regularly and not skipping breakfast is a very useful and important habit, because as confirmed by the above studies, this meal is extremely important to maintain normal functioning of the body and prevent the development of many diseases. There are the sources that I used, and thank you for your attention and interest.